A lot of people in my life think I'm crazy. And some people, if they found out, would probably call me a failure. Because I had grown up being told that money and school were what mattered most in life. And I had been sternly warned that giving up school would be probably the worst decision any person today could make. But since you're watching this video, I'm sure you can see that I did the thing that I was programmed to never think of doing. That's dropping out of university to start my life over as an artist. It was really, really tough at first. I had always been good at business and math as a child, and I had many abilities and hobbies. So I gave hope to many friends and family that I would be successful at a traditional, high-paying, high social status job. Getting into traditional university was easy for me. I spent 30 minutes on all of my applications and got early acceptances. My marks were high in school, and my extracurricular background was fruitful. I was a very good student, what many people wanted to be. But being a good student these days comes at some dire costs. After my spiritual awakening and meeting my twin flame, true love opened my eyes to how many years I spent slaving over social approval. I was addicted to stress, overworking, and productivity. I never rested because back then, I was taught that if I wasn't working, that I was worth nothing. If I didn't get a mark over 90, I would talk down on myself and treat myself worse to pump out another 90 the next project. I relied on hobbies and sports to prove to myself that I was valuable. If I wasn't the best, I was worth nothing. I realized that I told myself that very same sentence every day back then. A straight A, obedient, and good student in other people's eyes. For me, I realized that it was a socially conditioned, autopiloted hell that I would use to seek validation. And after seeing this so clearly, I could not unsee that reality. When I got rejected from the art school I thought was the only ticket to an artist's career, and instead went to the self-proclaimed number one university in Canada, I realized I could no longer autopilot like I did before. And it was very painful and almost impossible to work like I once did. You'll hear the phrase, love yourself, a lot these days. However, I believe that a lot of people misunderstand what that means. It means to love yourself to the degree where your own truth is all you need to move forward. It is to love yourself to the point where nobody's negative words can shake you. To the point where the only thing you need to feel valued is yourself. Did I value myself? I was forced to ask myself that question in this situation. Did I value myself enough to defy my parents, society, and my old self to be happy? Deep down, I knew that if I dropped university and maybe applied for another art school, that I would prosper. I knew that dropping university was my calling, and that it would be the best path for me. But was I ready to face what society had to say? I had to think such thoughts. It took me a long battle to realize what was in my heart, because I was busy trying to lie to myself that university was the right choice. Like many others, I spent time trying to repress and delay the truth to avoid the pain and the work that had to be done. But repressing your inner truth will never last forever. I started to fight with my parents, to the degree where every day felt like I was going to war. I cried a lot, almost every night, and many times I wondered if it was all worth it. Was I worth it? I asked myself that many times. But through every difficult argument and exchange of hurtful comments, I realized more and more that my parents were not capable of giving me the support that I needed for this decision. Many parents want to be good parents, but that does not mean that they have truly learned to love their child. And though I loved them, you cannot give the benefit of the doubt forever. They did not choose me because they weren't yet brave enough to break the walls of their mind for me. The timing just wasn't for it, and I realized I had to let them go emotionally. I finally had to admit to myself that what I thought before was reality was all an illusion to convince myself that I fit in to what society wanted for me. I had to acknowledge that I didn't have anyone at the time that I needed them. In the end, all I had was myself. So I spent the days facing the shadow of myself nobody ever wants to look in the eye. At the time, I was so sad that I had nothing to lose. And after a while of sitting in the dark, that's what I did. I decided to look at my shadow right in the eye. Because these struggles forced me to realize that in the end, I'm the person that lives with myself. I made the decision that I was going to be happy. I deserved unconditional love and nothing less. I decided that I had to be the one to provide that for myself. Before the new year, I actually received a tuition reward for my application. I was refunded for my first trimester and finally clicked that button to drop the second trimester. I submitted my application to OCAD's advertising program after realizing that I was meant to go there. I used the reward money to buy supplies, being fresh out of high school. And with these free days, I spent time on my art. I wake up in the morning and I smile, looking forward to having the day to myself. I practice routines, healthy meals, and connecting with myself. I am now mentally free to be whoever I wanted to be, and I no longer relied on people to tell me that I am worth something. All I needed was my new belief in the Creator, my spirit guides, and myself. And I started to feed myself love after finally realizing what it really was. In this world, unconditional love is very rare, but it's our time to start awakening to it. Once you find that for yourself, you become who you are meant to be. You become unstoppable, living in your soul's purpose. People still tell me that this was the worst decision of my life. People still think I'm a failure. But to me, true failure would have been abandoning myself. This decision was the turning point of my entire life. All I had to do was be brave enough to tell myself that my truth deserved to be believed by someone. And I decided that the believer was going to be me. Dropping school wasn't just freeing myself from the path I knew was never for me. Dropping school meant freeing myself from the people I worked to please all my life. It meant no longer pretending to be someone else for the sake of social approval and social image. I was now capable of understanding real love, feeding myself real love, and giving myself real love, and with that, also giving others real love. Love really is the answer to everything, every problem, and every pain in the world. This twin flame journey has been really amazing. It turned my old atheist self into someone who now knows God really does exist. It's just that the Creator can only reach you when you are your true self, not when you're pretending to be someone else. And now, many problems and questions I never knew the answer to, I now knew the answer. Love. That was the answer. And now that I live in love for myself every day, I want to spread my experiences and love to others through my art. Though everyone around me still thinks I'm crazy, I know my own potential. And I do not need anybody else's approval to believe in my own ability. Now that I'm starting to walk my destined path, I know I will be successful. Because in this world, I realized you really don't have to fight others for your place. There was always a place meant for you. It's just that that place was meant for the real you, not the you that you made up to please others. You have to fight yourself for that spot. So, here I am. I plan to paint and create pieces about the dreams and lessons I encountered during the lowest point in my life. And I want to inspire and give strength to people with my story. there's already too many doctors who truly don't care for the lives of their patients, and teachers that teach but do not care about changing the lives of their students. I want you to pursue what's really inside your heart, so you can feel the spot waiting for you. I was lost before, but I know what I'm here to do now, and I hope you all can follow me on my journey. Changing your life starts with a little seed of you deserve it. Because the only person who can decide if you deserve it is you.